A lot of people avoid fruit altogether when on a diet because of the fructose or the fruit sugars that they contain. But unless you're on a really low carb diet, you don't have to feel restricted when it comes to eating fruit. On the contrary, it can actually provide some unique advantages when it comes to losing weight. Eating fruits can help satisfy our cravings for sweets, fill our stomachs up while costing us only a small amount of calories, and they can reduce our hunger and appetite. The only thing is, even though all fruits are full of micronutrients, certain fruits that are high in sugar won't be as beneficial for weight loss as others. So today I want to go over the 10 best fruits that have been shown to actually help you lose weight and body fat. The first one might shock you, the banana. And a lot of people avoid bananas due to the amount of fructose they contain. But there's a trick that can really help you still enjoy bananas while dieting. It's true that most of the time when someone eats a banana, they'll be taking in more natural sugar than they would get from many other fruits. But when it comes to the amount of fructose in the banana, the levels increase the riper the banana becomes. Bananas in their unripened state have relatively low levels, and it's only when they start getting black marks on them that the sugar levels become a bigger problem. So a good tip is to only eat them in their unripened state while you're dieting. You want to eat them while they're still hard and they're slightly green. This will help fill you up without as large of a spike in blood sugar. Now, aside from that, bananas are also extremely nutrient dense. They contain high levels of potassium, magnesium, manganese, antioxidants, and fiber, along with a number of vitamins. Bananas also contain a special type of starch called resistant starch. This has been shown to fuel the healthy bacteria in the gut, which leads to the production of butyric acid. This acid reduces insulin resistance and improves the blood sugar response to the foods you eat, which will help you control your weight. Some studies also show that eating bananas significantly reduce blood glucose levels in type 2 diabetics and result in increased weight loss. One study group that ate banana starch lost an average of almost 3.5 pounds over 4 weeks compared to the control group who lost an average of a little over 0.5 pound. This doesn't mean that you can sit around and eat bananas until you're lean, but they are a nutritional powerhouse that can help you control your blood sugar and lose weight. The next fruit that'll help is the avocado. The average avocado has 60 calories and 9 grams of carbs, 7 of which are fiber. It also has 2 grams of protein and 15 grams of healthy monounsaturated fat. Avocados are full of plant sterols, which have been shown to lower cholesterol levels. Studies have also revealed that avocados help lower LDL, or the bad cholesterol levels, due to the high amount of monounsaturated fats that can be found within them. Research has also shown that swapping out vegetable and palm oils for avocado oil in cooking may help reduce visceral body fat around the belly area. As well as being low calorie, nutrient dense, and full of good fats, the avocado is also great at suppressing your appetite. That's right, most people don't know that a scoop of guacamole could be very effective at reducing hunger. In a study on the appetite suppressing effects of avocados, participants who ate half a fresh avocado with lunch reported a 28% decreased desire to eat for 4 hours afterwards. Let's move on to the next fruit for weight loss, which is the grapefruit. This is a very low calorie fruit that's also packed with healthy vitamins and minerals. Research has shown that it can also help you lose weight. In one study, a group of volunteers ate half a grapefruit before each meal, and they were compared to a control group that did not. The group that ate the grapefruit lost 5 times the amount of weight. Grapefruit's secret weapon is an enzyme called adenosine monophosphate activated protein kinase, or AMPK. This enzyme gets activated by a compound in grapefruit called NUT ketone. When it's activated, AMPK encourages glucose uptake. This then boosts the metabolism, leading to more calories burnt. AMPK is also released during exercise to encourage the body to use stored body fat for energy. An animal study on NUT ketone's ability to stimulate weight gain concluded that it significantly reduced the effects that high fat and high sugar diets had on weight gain, abdominal fat accumulation, and the development of high blood sugar, high insulin levels, and high leptin levels. High blood sugar and high insulin levels promote weight gain, and high leptin levels are a sign that you're leptin resistant. This means that your brain isn't getting the signal that tells you that you're full and you need to stop eating. So if grapefruit can help us manage blood sugar, leptin, and insulin a little better, that's a big plus. Grapefruit is also a great source of vitamin C, which is essential for fat metabolism. If you don't get enough vitamin C, your body's not able able to use stored fat. Red grapefruit in particular has been shown to be very effective at lowering triglyceride levels as well. Eating half a grapefruit every day may help you experience some of these benefits. Some people also eat half a grapefruit before each meal. But just a reminder, you shouldn't count on it alone as your only solution for weight loss, as many people do on fad diets like the grapefruit diet. If you eat a ton of processed junk food every day, the grapefruit you eat won't magically save you. Our next fruit is the apple. Apples are a powerful source of antioxidants. They're also a great source of both soluble and insoluble fiber. The insoluble fiber that's found in the skin of apples is filling, making it a helpful fruit for controlling our appetite. In one study, participants were divided into three groups, and they were given either three apples, three cookies, or three pears each day for 10 weeks. The apple group lost 2 pounds compared to 1.6 pounds for the pear group, and unsurprisingly, no changes in weight for the cookie group. Another thing about apples is that they help you control your blood sugar levels. The high fiber content of the apple means that the fruit sugars are released a lot slower in your bloodstream. The low glycemic nature of apples will help keep you full for longer, and it'll prevent blood sugar spikes and crashes. Next up, we got grapes, and even though grapes may be higher in sugar than some other fruits, grapes contain a concentration of phytochemicals known as polyphenols. Polyphenols help slow aging and they help protect us from cancer, although the exact mechanism that causes this is not clear yet. Grapes are also very nutritious. They're packed full of antioxidants, including beta carotene, lutein, selenium, and vitamins A, C, and E. They also contain resveratrol, which is a plant-derived compound that's found in the skin and seeds of grapes. Among its many other health-promoting benefits, it has been shown to stimulate the development of energy-consuming brown fat rather than obesity-causing white fat. Brown fat burns calories in order to create heat, whereas white fat sits in your body as a stored reserve of energy. Specifically, red grapes seem to provide the best benefit for weight loss because they contain ellagic acid, which has been shown to slow down the growth of existing fat cells in the body and to discourage the formation of new fat cells. However, with all that said, while grapes are great for overall health and weight loss, I already mentioned that they do contain quite a lot of natural sugar. So you don't wanna overindulge, and you should eat them in moderation. Moving on, we come to berries. Berries are full of antioxidants, which gives them their vibrant colors. The antioxidants in berries have been linked with lowering the risks of a number of cancers, in addition to helping with poor memory and counteracting the effects of old age. Berries are also a great source of dietary fiber, which will help you feel full for longer. In one study, people who were given 65-calorie berry snacks ate less food in the next meal than those who were given a candy snack with the same number of calories. There's also evidence that eating berries will help to bring down unhealthy cholesterol levels and reduce blood pressure. Out of all the different kinds of berries, blackberries, strawberries, and raspberries are lower in carbohydrates as opposed to blueberries, which are also very healthy, but they're higher in sugar. Berries also have a high flavonoid count. Flavonoids are believed to have a beneficial effect on the cardiovascular system, having the ability to reduce cardiovascular risk factors. Blackberries in particular have a very high flavonoid count. Our next favorite fruit is the kiwi. A single kiwi has just 42 calories and is one of the most nutrient-dense foods out there. They contain over 20 important micronutrients, including vitamin A, vitamin E, B6, B12, potassium, and copper. Kiwis have also been shown to reduce blood sugar levels after eating high sugar foods. Again, this doesn't justify eating candy as long as you eat a kiwi with it, but in one study, researchers looked at the blood glucose response after eating a high carb breakfast with and without added kiwi. The hunger levels after 3 hours were also measured. The kiwi group had much lower blood glucose level spikes over the entire 3 hours. They were also a lot less hungry than the other group after the 3 hours. On top of that, kiwis are also very high in omega-3 fatty acids. As well as supporting brain health, omega-3s have also been shown to remove triglycerides from the bloodstream and to lower inflammation while simultaneously strengthening your joints and tendons. All of this makes the kiwi a smart choice for a solid weight loss snack. But again, if you want to see quick weight loss, use kiwis as a replacement for higher calorie, less nutritious snacking options. Moving on, our next fruit is the orange. Similar to grapefruit, this is another low-calorie food that's high in vitamin C and fiber. So it probably won't surprise you to learn that oranges were shown to be 4 times more filling than croissants and twice as filling as a muesli bar. The problem is that a lot of people would much rather just down a glass of orange juice instead of eating the whole fruit, and that's a big mistake. Not only do many brands of orange juice contain added sugar, but the fiber that's supposed to fill you up when eating an orange gets removed. Studies have shown that eating the fruit rather than just drinking the juice fills you up a lot more and reduces your caloric intake. Also, one orange has about 9 grams of sugar and only 45 calories. Compare that to a less filling glass of 100% orange juice that has 23 grams of sugar and 110 calories, and you'll quickly see why you should go with the fruit over the fruit juice. Next up, we've got passion fruit. Passion fruit is the lowest calorie fruit that we've come across today, with just 17 calories in an average piece. They're high in vitamin A, vitamin C, iron, and potassium, but where they excel especially for such a small fruit is in their very high dietary fiber count. 5 passion fruits will provide you with 42% of your total recommended daily intake of fiber without even exceeding 100 calories. Also, the seeds inside of passion fruit contain a compound called piceatonol. Some preliminary research has linked piceatonol with lowering of blood pressure and improved insulin sensitivity. Finally, we've made it to the last type of fruit that can help you with your weight loss efforts, and that's stone fruit. These include peaches, nectarines, plums, and other fruits that have a hard pit inside of them. As well as being low on the glycemic index, stone fruit are low in calories and high in healthy nutrients. Most stone fruit will only cost you between 75 and 100 calories per serving. One study found that some of the bioactive compounds found in peaches, plums, and nectarines could help to ward off metabolic syndrome, which is the name given to a group of risk factors such as obesity and inflammation that increase the risk of heart disease. Metabolic syndrome also makes it very difficult to lose weight. The researchers identified phenolic compounds in these stone fruits that were able to reduce the oxidation of bad cholesterol, or LDL, which contributes to cardiovascular disease. Well, that's it, guys. I really hope this video has helped you out. If you enjoyed it, make sure you subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so you can be notified whenever I release more free tips and tricks, just like the ones you found in this video. Also, if you're looking for a complete step-by-step done-for-you approach to lose a lot of weight and body fat in the next 6 weeks without having to go through years of trial and error, then check out my 6-week challenge. The challenge is designed to help hold you accountable in a way like you've never experienced with any other program before. We've already helped over 10,000 people transform their body and lose 20 pounds or 5% of their body fat in only 6 weeks. With this challenge, you'll get a customized meal plan, a progressive 42-day workout plan designed to help you burn fat fast, and an accountability coach to help guide you through the entire process. And even though I'm sure that you're gonna do incredibly well with this challenge and you're gonna be incredibly satisfied with your results at the end of the 6 weeks, to give you even further incentive to follow through, as long as you put your best foot forward and actually complete the challenge, you can have the whole course and all the materials for free. To find out more, click the link below in the description or visit my website directly at gravitytransformation.com. I'll see you guys soon.